very warm welcome once again on campus, Eurosports magazine show dedicated to the world of university sports. This week we're in Korea, visiting the city of Gwangju, which will host the Summer Universiade in 2015. Last month, Gwangju staged the World University Badminton Championships, an opportunity for Koreans to enjoy one of the country's most popular sports right on its doorstep, and we'll meet a lost pole too. And we'll be speaking to a Korean national hero, the 20-year-old who this year became South Korea's first ever Olympic gold medal gymnast, as well as catching up on the progress of the Universiade torch relay, all to come on campus. The city of Gwangju is the sixth largest in the Korean Republic. It's located in the southeast region of the country, in the South Jeolla province, some 270 kilometers from the capital Seoul. In 2009, Gwangju was awarded hosting rights for the 28th Summer Universiade. Gwangju has a long university tradition. Chosun University is one of the oldest and most prestigious in South Korea and was founded in 1946. Around 33,000 students are enrolled here. In May 1980, Gwangju was the setting for one of the most dramatic incidents in the modern history of South Korea. Student and civil demonstrations took place in Gwangju against the newly installed military government. Democratic movements controlled the city for 9 days until the government sent 20,000 troops supported by helicopters and tanks to brutally crush the uprising. It's estimated that up to 200 people were killed. Thousands were injured. The Gwangju Democratic Uprising is the most tragic and shameful incident in Korean history. Over 30 years later, in May 2001, a May 18th cemetery and memorial center was opened. The full truth concerning the Gwangju Democratic Uprising has yet to be discovered. It's been a long time only part of Gwangju's history. Now it's part of the history of the country.
1994년부터 조성을 시작해서 1997년도에 완공이 됐습니다.
The Universiade will be a perfect opportunity to introduce this history to a wider audience and to help Korea to make peace with this dramatic incident. One of the main concepts of Gwangju 2015 is the Peace Versiade. The most ambitious aspect of the concept, though, is a sporting reunification of South and North Korea during the Games. The goal is that both countries would compete as a united team. A local organizing committee is working with the UN on this project.
United Nations Secretary General Mr. Ban Ki-moon expressed support from United Nations on the single Korean team. She's saying, "We are exploring the possibility of the first ever united Korean team on the close collaboration between Gwangju and the United Nations. There is a high possibility to realize a single Korean team at the Universiade 2015.
The Gwangju 2015 general concept is named EPIC. This stands for Ecology, Peace, IT Industry, Internet and Technology, and culture. All these elements will make the 2015 Universiade special. The organization of Gwangju 2015 follows eco-friendly lines, and the emphasis is on renovation of most of the existing facilities. Of a total of 73 venues, 38 for competition and 35 for training, only two will be newly built, a multi-sport complex and the aquatic center. The city's biggest international sporting venue is the home ground of Gwangju. It staged matches in the 2002 World Cup. Here, the opening ceremony, athletics and football tournament will be staged in 2015. We met a European player from the local team who explained to us Korean football's roots in university culture.
This is so different style, like in Europe, you know, because we don't have like that championship, like if university, you know, they're following that, they're watching all the game. I watch the game of university, they have a lot of supporters, so it's, for me, it's something new. But when they told me that all of these players, they are like from university, I was really surprised, because it's like, it's not amateur, but when I saw the way they play, I say like, I couldn't believe that they are not professional before.
men's and women's teams have won football titles at past Universiades, they will surely be competitive again in 2015. Another team sport will be included in the Universiade schedule in 2015, handball. It became a very popular sport in South Korea, especially for women, after they won the gold medal at the Seoul 1988 Olympics and the 1995 world title. I was born and I grew up in Gwangju, and I'm pleased to have the Universiade in my hometown. It's a real honour for us, especially because handball originally wasn't included in the programme, and the organisation included it specifically for Gwangju 2015. It'll be a great opportunity for handball players from all over the world to discover Korean handball. Badminton was part of the Universiade program for the first time in Bangkok 5 years ago and for the second time in Shenzhen. South Korea was successful in Shenzhen with two gold medals. The Korean University national team is aiming for the same results at home in 2015. Badminton became very popular in South Korea, and especially here in Gwangju, after Lee Yong-dae, who is from this region, won the gold medal at the Beijing Olympics in 2008. Nowadays, we can say it's the number one sport in our daily activities at college and university. The most popular sport in South Korea, though, is baseball, and the Gwangju Tigers are one of the most successful teams in the league's history. Baseball was twice on the Universiade program in 1993 and 1995. South Korea lost twice in the final against Cuba. The Gwangju tournament will use the installation of the future Kia Tigers ultra-modern new stadium. We're building the new stadium in an environmentally friendly way and with all the convenience for the access of disabled people. The concept of this new baseball stadium is to satisfy spectators. It'll be a unique stadium in South Korea and will be finished a year before the Universiade. If baseball is the most popular sport in South Korea, golf isn't far behind. It's obvious that golf must be on the program in 2015 in a country where seven players are in the world's top 10 of women. The competition will be played at the Naju Club. FISU's technical committee, led by Chair John Warnock, visited the city of Gwangju at the end of October to inspect the overall preparation for the 2015 Universiade. The CTI is composed of 34 experts in three groups from 20 game events. Inspection teams have had intensive meetings with the staff in charge regarding overall matters, including competition operation, new construction or renovation of venues.
My expectations are quite high, and they still are. It mainly reflects on the fact that we had a great competition in Daegu in 2003. And so I expect at least similar, if not better, up here in Gwangju. I don't think that will be a problem. They already have demonstrated by some of the new builds that we've seen that they have a terrific desire to put the facilities in place. But like everything else, the proof of the pudding is if the facilities are there in time when you want them.
Mark van den Pla, FISU director for the Summer Universiade, identifies the key areas for improvement.
La construction de certains sites, le village des athlètes, le site aquatique.
Building of some of the venues, the athletes' village, the aquatic center, the complex for volleyball and gymnastics finals. Another point is the hotel capacity of the city. We have to inspect closely which hotels could be used. The last point is the future signing of key contracts, like the one for the timing and scoring, and the contract for the TV production.
Le chronométrage et pour les résultats, ainsi que le contrat avec le télédiffuseur.
South Korea will organise the Asian Games in 2014 and the Summer Universiade and Military Games a year later. There's a lot happening. It's a big challenge for the country.
avec lesquels nous entretenons des relations étroites.
Korean National Sports Federations, which we have very close relationships with, will have to work on three different events, which means it'll be very difficult for them. Moreover, the three organizing committees will have to find various partners and sponsors in a very small local market. The next CTI inspection in Gwangju will come next year. It will be the occasion for FISU to check the developments over the previous 12 months. athletes from 19 countries participated in the World University Badminton Championships at the beginning of November in Gwangju. In the men's doubles final, the Olympic champion Yong Dae-li, he was crowned in Beijing 2008 in the mixed doubles, partnered up with Kim Ki-jung against Chinese Taipei. The first set was a tied affair. Ki-jung did his share of the hard work thanks to powerful smashes. Taipei tied at 18-all, and South Korea scored three straight points and then went on to dominate the second set and eventually defeated their opponents 21-18, 21-16. The German pair Andreas Heinz and Max Schwenger took the bronze medal. Japan, Miri Ichimaru and Shiho Tanaka face the Chinese Taipei duo of Pai and Tai in the women's doubles final. Ichimaru and Tanaka are considered one of the most experienced pairings, playing together regularly, have been as ranked as high as the world's top 60. The pair from Chinese Taipei lost 22-20 and 22-11. But they were successful in the singles event, as we'll see in just a moment. The golden game for the men's singles was on between the second seed Kai Wen and the number one seed Pablo Abian. Abian struggled twice over three sets during his route through to the final against Koji Naito of Japan in round three and Kuei Chun-shin from Chinese Taipei in the semi-final. While Kai Wen hadn't lost a single set before the final, the gold medal went to Kai Wen, who moved up a step from his 2011 Universiade silver medal, and he repeated his success over Pablo Abian from the quarterfinals in Shenzhen. Bouncing back from an early first game deficit to win easily 21-16, 21-8. Lee Dong-koin from Korea and Ernesto Velasquez from Spain shared third place. The women's singles final featured two players from Chinese Taipei, Su Ying Tai and Sao Ma Pai. They played the women's doubles final. Unfortunately for Pai, she injured her wrist and had to give up the match at the end of the first set, won by Tai 21-13. She left the championship title to the top seed Su Ying Tai. Kim Soo Yoon from Korea and Haruzo Suzuki earned the bronze medals. After winning the title with Yong Dae-li in the men's doubles tournament, Ki-jung Kim from South Korea was aiming for a second gold medal in the mixed doubles with So Yong Kim. They faced another Korean team in the finals, Ji-wook Kang and Chan-mi Kim, beat the top-seeded Polish pair of Wojciech Skudlaczyk and Agnieszka Wojciechowska in the semi-final 21-19 and 21-17. Ji-wook Kang and Chan-mi Kim won the first set 22-20 after a long rally at set point. Kim and So Young Kim won another tight second set, 21-19. Eventually made it all the way to the gold medal after a third set won 21-17. Excellent return for the Republic of Korea. Those seven medals in total, including two golds, one for Chinese Taipei, Japan and China. Hwasun, 20 kilometres from Gwangju, is the training base for Korean university teams. And amidst a sea of locals, we spotted some Polish jerseys. Wojciech Skidlarczyk was one such European visitor training with Korean athletes. After finishing third in 2010, the Poznan University student hoped he could improve in the 2012 Universiade.
Number one,
back bronze again.
But the was two very strong Korean pair. We lost against one of them. We played quite good match. Of course, maybe it's better if you can beat maybe silver or gold medal. But also we are tired after the team event, and also I played men's double. So it's also, I think, very good result for me.
After the Worlds, Wojciech decided to remain in Korea for another month to try and improve his techniques. For a European athlete, it's a unique opportunity to be confronted with
every
Korean
year,
talent.
Playing more good top class player like this time, like medalist of Olympic, like Lee Young-dae played this competition. Also another players from the national team of Korea. Also Taipei team was very strong here. Japanese, I think every time the competition are stronger.
Wojciech was able to observe firsthand that badminton is a very popular sport in Korea with great facilities and a quasi-professional organizational structure.
I was impressed about the organization and how much people was around to organize this kind of competition, because I think it's more than 200 people, so it's amazing, and I think in Europe it's not possible so much people work with the competition like that.
26-year-old Wojciech, it was a great experience. Besides sport, it was also a cultural lesson for he and his fellow Poles.
I'm really like impressive here because it's totally different culture from like we saw how people live here, how the what people eating here. It's totally different than Europe, but it's very good experience, and I think it's one of the best travel in my life.
Well, last week, Wojciech was involved in the Korea Badminton Grand Prix with his teammate Lukasz Modern. They were the only Europeans present, and despite defeat in the second round, they enjoyed it immensely. Stay with us on campus. In part three, we'll meet a man who became the first Korean to win an Olympic title in gymnastics, thanks to a jump which is now named after him. All to come after the break. Welcome back to campus and our career special, where it's time to meet a national hero, Hak Seon Yang, who at the London Games became the first South Korean gymnast to win an Olympic gold medal. His performance was enhanced by a three-twist front somersault invented by him. He's still the only gymnast to execute it in the world. He did it perfectly on August 6th at the North Greenwich Arena. I saw my result. I thought I'd done a good performance, but it didn't really sink in. I also wondered whether it was good enough to get the gold medal. I'm pragmatic. I progress step by step, and I'm not someone who is overly ambitious. I face the realities in my life. I didn't start gymnastics as someone who was desperately wanting to get a gold medal. I don't like being alone at home, and I also don't like being bored in my life. That's why I started gymnastics. It got more fun when I completed new skills, and my parents were very pleased when I won a medal. They have been my motivation so far. Born in Gwangju, Hak Seon Yang is now a student at the prestigious Korean National Sport University of Seoul, which has produced numerous Olympic champions. I've chosen the Korean National Sport University of Seoul because it's a place where I'm able to practice easily, and there are lots of good teachers. Additionally, professors in the sport department already knew me when I was in the young categories, and my first coach from high school also graduated from this sports department. The reason I like this university is that it's convenient for athletes. I'm able to carry on my studying and at the same time to do my training in Taeryeong, the National Sport Training Center. Hak Seon Yang was born into poverty in 1992 in Gwangju. His family lived in a shanty town before moving to the countryside in 2010. Hak still very attached to Gwangju and wants to participate in the Universiade. Gwangju is my hometown where I was born and I grew up, so I'd like to show my performance to the local people. Watching gymnastics at the competition is totally different to watching it on TV, so I want to go to the Universiade to show my skills and the best performances. Many gymnastics champions like Evgenia Kaneyeva, the double Olympic gold medalist from Beijing and London, took part in Universiades earlier in their career. So, even after being crowned at world level.
The
Universiade has an age limit of 28 among university students. In my opinion, this is a good platform for them before the World Championships or the Olympics. Universiades allow young athletes to show their performances and their true level. The best university athletes from their countries are selected, and they're often the best athletes in the world. The Universiade 2015 will be a perfect rehearsal for Haxion Yang, who will still only be 23 years of age. I only made my next goal right after the London Olympics. It means I would like to get the gold again in Brazil, so I'll continue to practice and prepare for the 2016 Olympic Games. If everything goes well, I'm sure that I'll be in good shape. The Universiade program fits perfectly with my training routine, because I want the gold at Rio. Well, Haxion Yang knows there will be high expectations, maybe more so than ever, in 2015. Time now for some Universiade news, and the historic tall ship Sedov, that's carrying the lantern containing the 2013 Summer Universiade flame, entered the port of Apia in Samoa and made a leap into the future by crossing into a different time zone. Sedov left St. Petersburg in May and will finish the Kazan Torch World Tour in January in Vladivostok. The 2012 University Sambo World Cup, another test event for the 27th Universiade, was held at the AK Bars Wrestling Palace in Kazan from November 20th to December 3rd. Sambo is a Russian-inspired martial art and translates literally as self-defense without weapons. More than 200 Sambo wrestlers from 40 countries competed for podium spots in 18 medal events. Team Russia, the hosts, won the most medals, 11 in total, including 3 golds. Exactly 1 year before the opening ceremony of the Trentino 2013 Winter Universiade, the organising committee staged a symbolic ceremony in Duomo Square in Trento, in the same location which will host the official opening ceremony, a parade of the 3,000 participants from 50 different nations. In this career special on campus, it's time to look back on the Daegu 2003 Universiade and a very special performance from 5,000-metre runner Ukrainian Sergei Lebed. The 9-time cross-country European champion achieved an almost unique performance by winning a third Universiade title in a row in athletics. He's only the fourth man to achieve that feat after István Bagula, Hungarian pole vaulter, Igor Ovenesian, long jumper, and Sepp Zielbauer, Austrian triple jumper. Sergei is not a track specialist and prefers racing cross-country, but in 1999 he participated and won the 5,000 metres at Palma de Mallorca, 13:37.52. In Beijing in 2001, Sergei returned to the Universiade after a disappointing 7th place at the Sydney Olympics. He won in 13:44.24 ahead of Mikhail Yeginov of Russia and Switzerland's Christian Belz. In the Daegu race in 2003, Lebed won in 13:50.94 ahead of German Jan Fitchen, Moroccan Hisham Baladi. A student from Dnipropetrovsk National University was 28 at the time, and his last Universiade, but he entered the history box of university sports. That's all for now, but join us next month on campus when in episode 6 we'll sum up all the main university sporting events of 2012, and we'll have two special focus on the Speed Skating World Championships in Zakopane and the Tennis Masters in Aix-en-Provence. That's all from now. Thanks for your company. Bye-bye.